So I'm just going to invite you just to take a moment to connect with your breath. So closing the eyes, just simply watching the flow of breath in and out of the body. Just taking one or two deeper breaths, and as you breathe out, just that feeling of letting go, just letting go of the tension in the body, just letting go of the busyness of the mind, letting go of any thoughts that aren't serving us, any worries, any anxieties. Just allowing this focus on the breath just to bring us more and more into the present moment. Just taking a moment to imagine and connect with all the other people joining us right now in this moment, in different parts of the country and maybe different parts of the world, and just forming a bridge to all these different hearts. So let's start by taking a moment to sound Om together. Just allowing your voice to sing freely and naturally. Just letting go of any judgment or conditioning, any ideas of right or wrong. Just allowing our voices to be this pure expression of our hearts. those of you who don't know, Hanuman is the pure embodiment of the love, of devotion, of bhakti. And everything he does is through his love for Ram and Sita. And through this great devotion, he's able to achieve these incredible things. So we're going to begin with a Hanuman mantra. Om Hum Hanumate Namaha. Om Hum Hanumate Namaha. So this is calling on. See, Hanuman is this pure being of devotion, of love, of strength, of humility, of service, and asking that these qualities we can begin to inhibit as well. Inhibit, is that the right word? Maybe not. Imbibe? Sing Shree Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Shree Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Om Amen.
Shree.
just taking a moment to enjoy the stillness, enjoy the silence. Just bathing in that shared silence. So welcome to my home, the lighthouse. I know a number of you would have chanted with me here over the years, and I quite often chant here on a Monday evening. So in fact, in under normal circumstances, we'd have been singing this evening with a group here. So I'm just thinking that maybe once things return to normal and people can come here, it'd be kind of fun to live stream occasionally as well, so you can get to hear everyone else's voices, not just mine. So yeah, welcome to this space. Enjoy the altar. We have some beautiful things here. There's a lovely statue of Hanuman here we just sang to. And in the Ramayana, there's a moment where Ram says to Hanuman, he says, "How do you think of me?" And Hanuman says, "When I forget who I am, I serve you. And when I remember who I am, you and I are one." So this practice of Kirtan Bhakti Yoga just helps us to remember our oneness through repeating these divine names over and over again. Oh, we start to break down those walls of separation and begin to melt as one, to join as one. So this next one is in praise of the goddess Devi and divine mother Ambe Ma. So the words are Jai Shri Devi Namo Namah, Jai Shri Devi Namo Namah, and then Ambe Ma. So when we sing to Divine Mother, I feel like we are strengthening the quality of unconditional love within ourselves. And this particular chant begins with a few English words with an introduction that speaks to that quality of love.
Namo Namah. Help me, man.
So I hope the sound is okay. Hopefully the harmonium is not too loud, and I hope it's coming over okay. I'm trying to see through the phone. I think the light's okay. So it's getting dark now. I'm going to sing another Ma chant. And the words are Jay Ambe Jagadambe. Jagadambe, Jagadambe, Mother of the World, Jagadambe. And then Mata Bhavani, Mata Bhavani. And then back to Jagadambe again. So Jagadambe, Jagadambe, Mata Bhavani, Jagadambe. And then simply Jema, Jema, Jema.
Jagadambe. Bhavani Jima, 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 J
So, as this is my first live stream, Kirtan, I really have to end with this place. So those of you who sing with me regularly, or even just occasionally, will know that this tends to get sung quite often. It's a great favourite of mine and other people's, and it just, I never get tired of singing these words. I'll just recite the poem for you. It's a poem by Hafez, the Sufi poet. And the words are, "This place where you are right now, God circled on a map for you. Wherever your eyes and arms and heart can move, against the earth and sky, the beloved has bowed there. Our beloved has bowed there, knowing you are coming." So these words, since I put them to the music back in probably about 2011 now, just seem to have been a kind of a way of life. This just feeling that this place, wherever we are, however challenging, however difficult, that somehow this is the right place. This is where the wisdom is. This is where the growth is. This is where the learning is. So even in those dark times or difficult times, then we just know that there's this greater wisdom at play. And if we can just surrender to that, if we can just come to a place of acceptance and trust, then we can start to navigate our way through life with a little bit more ease, perhaps. I remember, it's probably a couple of years ago now, that I was involved in this little minor car crash, which was completely my fault, and I was really annoyed with myself because it was just, I could have avoided it. You know, I was literally 30 seconds down the road contemplating whether to do a U-turn and go the other way. But it seems like I was irresistibly drawn towards
towards this car crash. And I got home and I was, you know, really cross, and I messed the car up and messed someone else's car up. Thankfully, no one was injured. And I posted on Facebook, as we tend to do in this social media age, oh, you know, I've just done this. And everyone was being really sympathetic and sending nice supportive messages. And then someone posted, this place where you are right now, God circled on a map for you. And as soon as I saw those words, I just took a breath and I just dropped into that place of surrender and acceptance. And yeah, I was very grateful. I wish I could remember who did that, but it was, I had a taste of my own medicine having told people to use it. I'd forgotten myself that this place was where I was meant to be. So we sing this place a few times, and then we go into Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So this mantra also brings together the Hindu and Muslim faiths, which is also really important right now with what was happening and maybe still happening in India. So this is a prayer that whatever faith we may adhere to, that we can come together and find our similarities rather than look for the differences.
Thou be nowhere.
Krishna, 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 Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Namo, Hare Namo, Namo Namo, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Namo, Hare Namo, Namo Namo, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Namo, Hare Namo, Rama Namo, Hare Hare. Against the earth and sky, the beloved has bowed there, and our beloved has bowed there nowhere. You are coming, you. Against the earth and sky, the beloved has bowed there, and our beloved
Just